Hello, I'm Joe Ramey, and today is Monday, December the 1st. This presentation will look back to climate numbers for the month of November and the fall season, and then look ahead to the latest outlook for the month of December and the winter and spring seasons to come. Here is a November climate summary for regional airports. In the upper portion of this slide are the monthly precipitation amounts. In parentheses are the departures from normal. You can see that all area airports were drier than normal. Average monthly temperatures in the lower half of the slide were below normal except at Durango. Generally, November 2014 produced a storm track that was north and east of this forecast area. Here is a summary of the meteorological fall season of September, October, and November. Overall, this fall season started out wet, but ended up generally drier than normal, except at Durango and Vernal. Average temperatures in the lower half of the slide came in above normal, except at Grand Junction. Here are annual precipitation graphs for three representative sites in this forecast area: Craig in northwest Colorado, Grand Junction in west central Colorado, and Cortez in the southwest. You can see that the upcoming months of December and January are normally one of the driest periods of the year. Now let's turn to the forecast for the upcoming winter and spring seasons. Out at this time frame, forecasters are no longer tracking individual storms, but are looking to the state of the Pacific Ocean for clues to the future storm track and intensity. In the equatorial eastern Pacific, between the dateline and the coast of Ecuador, is the Niño 3.4 region outlined here by the red box. Warmer than normal temperatures in this region are called El Niño. Colder than normal temperatures define La Niña. Together, these are the warm and cold phases of the El Niño Southern Oscillation, or ENSO for short. Here is a chart showing current sea surface temperature departure from normal within the Niño 3.4 region, roughly enclosed in the red box. The ocean temperatures are showing signs of warming, though we officially remain in ENSO neutral conditions. Here is a somewhat technical slide showing the forecast from numerous models of how temperatures within the Niño 3.4 region will vary into the winter and spring of 2015 from left to right across the graph. You can see the majority of the forecast lines rise above the 0.5 line, indicating an El Niño winter is on the way. Some of the forecast models indicate that we will not quite make El Niño conditions this cold season. The best forecast is for a weak El Niño event. El Niño winters tend to flatten the jet stream along the southern tier of states. One storm pattern that occurs during El Niño cold seasons are low-pressure systems that dig to the south of the Four Corners region. This pattern often brings wet weather to the desert southwest, as far north as the Four Corners. Here is the outlook for this month of December from the Climate Prediction Center. On the left is the temperature probability chart. The large brown area centered along the west coast indicates a shift of probabilities towards warmer than normal conditions, stretching into eastern Utah and far western Colorado. On the right, the precipitation probability chart indicates an area of increased chances of wetter than normal conditions for the Four Corners region. For the rest of this forecast area, there is less forecast skill, so there are equal chances of above, near, and below normal precipitation. This brings us to the Climate Prediction Center's outlook for the winter season of December, January, February. On the left chart, you see our shift towards warmer probabilities still extends into eastern Utah and far western Colorado. The right chart of precipitation probabilities also still shows an increased chance of wetter than normal in the southern portion of our forecast area. Otherwise, much of our forecast area remains in the white equal chances area, showing no forecast skill for temperatures or precipitation. Moving on into the spring, here is the Climate Prediction Center's outlook for the February, March, April season. On the left, the warm shift continues for the western half of this forecast area. On the right, you can see that now the odds are for a wetter than normal spring across the entire forecast area. If El Niño conditions do indeed emerge as forecast this winter, here is what has happened during the four most recent El Niños. This subset of El Niño shows a tendency for a drier than normal winter, with only one of the winter months recording above normal snowfall each year. In the right column, the four spring seasons show a tendency towards wetter than normal conditions. This concludes this fall climate summary and winter to spring seasonal outlook. You can follow the National Weather Service in Grand Junction on our website at www.weather.gov/GJT or on Facebook or Twitter. Thank you for listening and have a great winter.